Oke, right. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How are you, viewers? I'm Reski Muhammad Adil ZN from Local A English Department 2019. So here in this video, I would like to talk about how children learn a language. So in this part, I would like to retell about a few of material. So the first one is the develop of speech productions, from vocalizations to babbling the speech. Prior to uttering speech, sound infants make a variety of sounds, crying, echoing, and growling. Around the 7th month, children ordinary behind to babble to produce what may be described as repeated syllables. The productions of sounds using the intonations contours of the first language is obviously a learned pinyin, because when infants babble, they follow the intonation contours of the language they hear. So now it's about babbling the speech. The infant doesn't intentionally make a particular babbling sounds which occur. They seem to happen by chance coordination of speech articulators. While a meaningful speech is the sounds must not uttered at random, must match previously heard sounds which are conventionally associated with certain object, need, and so on. The sounds is created by speech articulators. Explaining the acquisitions of consonants and vowels in the meaningful speech phrase, it appears that consonants are acquired in the front to back order, where front and back refer to the origin of the articulation of the sounds. Vowel seems to be acquired in a back to front order. And here we have kinds of early speech stages. There are naming, holoplastic, telegraphic, and morphemic. Naming is one word utterances. Children can be said to have learned their first word when they are able to utter a recognized speech form, and when it is done in conjunction with some object or even in the environment. Ordinary, children speak along with physical movement, holoclastic functions, one word utterance. Children do not only use single words to refer to objects, they also use single words to express complex truths when involves those objects. I'm in love with the shape of you. I'm sorry, but telegraphic speech, 2 and 3 words utterances, variety of purposes and semantic relations. The child uses language to request, when, name, reviews, beg, brag, answer, and inform. Low incidence of functions words, rarely use articles, prepositions, and opula B. Close approximation of the language word order, speak word and write order, synthetic versus semantic analysis, morpheme acquisitions, 1, 2, and 3 word utterances have been acquired. Children have something on which elaborate. They start to add functions, words, and inflections to their utterances. So now here we have the Brown morpheme acquisition research. Brown focused on the acquisition of different functions, words, and inflections of English. He found that children acquired the morphemes and a relatively similar order. Brown checked frequencies of the occurrence of the morphemes in adult speech to see if more highly used morphemes were learned faster by a child. He found no relationship. He considered that the order reflected and increasing order of semantic of grammatical complexity.
Excuse me, Bob.
And here we have Stenberg's explanation about the pro-morpheme acquisition research.
Excuse me.
The order of morpheme acquisition can be explained directly and simply by applying psychological learning principle. Variable 1, easy to observability of referent. The more easily a child can see or hear or otherwise experience the relevance. Variable 2, meaningfulness of relevance. It's been that the child who desires to communicate will be learned faster than which lack such interest. The variable 3 is distinctiveness of sound and signaling reverent. It means that the child is able to identify the speech sound that signals that morpheme. Morpheme reverents which are more observable and carry more meaning will be more quickly learned than those which are not. Okay, right. I think that's all from me. I'm so sorry for my mistake or my grammatical error in this video. Thanks a lot for your understanding, and thank you so much for watching.